Hi students, in last class we have discussed about the structure of the optical fiber and how the light is transmitted in the form of a total internal reflection. Today we are going to discuss about the numerical aperture and acceptance angle of the optical fiber. Numerical aperture is nothing but light propagating capacity within the fiber. Here, whatever the data has to be sent into the fiber, it must convert in the form of a light. The light is launched as OA. OA is a ray of light which makes an angle of incidence I. This is core axis. This is cladding. Core, cladding. The refractive index of the core is N1. Refractive index of the cladding is N2. Here, when the OA is incident, it makes an angle I and the light is refracted inside because the light is arriving from the rarer medium into denser medium. So whenever the light is coming from the rarer into denser, it bent towards the normal. So now I am going to apply Snell's law at air core surface, sine of angle of incidence, sine of angle of refraction theta is equal to the denser medium N1, rarer medium refractive index is N0. So now the sine I is equal to N1 by N0. So now the sine theta is multiplied here, it is sine theta. So now the sine theta, it becomes into N1 by N0 into square root of 1 minus cos square theta. This is equation number 1. The sine theta, it is written in the form of 1 minus cos square theta. Now, we come to core cladding surface. The light arriving from the core, which is denser medium, this is the rarer medium, it bent away from the normal. This is angle of incidence theta c. At critical angle, the light is whose refractive index is r is equal to 90 degree, because the light is just laying on the surface of the core and cladding. So now I am going to apply the Snell's law at core cladding interface. So sine of the angle of incidence phi c sine 90 degree is equal to, again the denser medium is N2, rarer medium is N1. Sine 90 is equal to 1, so sine phi c is equal to N2 by N1. This is equation number 2. As we know, in right triangle ABC, the sum of all the angles phi c theta plus 90, phi c theta plus 90 is equal to 180 degree. So phi c is equal to 180 minus 90 minus theta. Phi c is equal to 90 minus theta. This is equation number 2. Now, by using phi c value in the equation 2, so equation 2, it becomes into the sine 90 minus theta is equal to N2 by N1. Sine 90 minus theta is equal to cos theta N2 by N1. This is equation number 4. Now, you use equation 4 in the equation number 1 by substituting equation 4 in equation 1, we get sine I becomes into I max is equal to N1 by N0 root of 1 minus N2 squared by N1 squared. When you take LCM, it is N1 by N0 root of N1 squared minus N2 squared whole divided by N1. N1 and N1 cancel, this becomes into 1. So sine I max, sine I max is equal to root of n1 square minus n2 square. Since n0 is equal to 1, this is called as numerical aperture. The numerical aperture is nothing but sine I max, that is equal to root of n2 square minus n square. Now the I max is called as the acceptance angle, so that is equal to sine inverse of root of n1 square minus n2 square.